Hello everybody, hope that you're doing very well and welcome to this trading video that I have for you. It is going to be live trading Bitcoin and you're going to be able to see a glimpse into the theory behind the trades that I'm taking, why I'm taking them, how I'm taking them right in the moment as it was happening. This is a live stream from last night's Contenders live stream, which is obviously for the Contenders and Champions. And so you're excited for what you're about to see because I promise you it's so good. This is some of the feedback from some of the Contenders and Champions last night of what they thought of the stream. As you're going to see, hopefully you can take inspiration from the stream and also see how it was a very profitable for everybody that watched it. But I really hope that you enjoy. Stay tuned all the way through the video. Take lots of notes and hope you enjoy and have a brilliant new year. Thanks, everybody. Enjoy. Good evening, everybody. Hope that you are well and welcome to tonight's Contenders live stream, 30th of December. And it's kind of just another one of these. There's no lesson planned. It's just a bit of a Christmas special, I suppose, New Year special stream where we're just going to go over the charts. And we actually have some really, really, really nice price movement. 10 minutes ago, more or less, we hit another all-time high. 20 minutes ago, 30 minutes ago, we just hit a new all-time high. So this is literally all-time high right now on Bitcoin. Really, really, really good, I suppose, for me to commentate over this. Today, if you've been following in the chat, you've know I've called it pretty amazing, all of this. Even the steps of adding up as we were getting up to the resistance, the levels to be buying today of support. Oh my, it's just been so, so technical. Like truly, 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 truly an amazingly technical day, which I don't think is a surprise to anybody. I don't really think it's a surprise. I was expecting the breakout today to a new all-time high and we got it. I'm long on, again, I'm still long on every single account I own. Every single account I own is in longs. This includes my swing trades, which I've told you all. Still in all my swing trade longs, in new day trade longs, in new scalp trade longs. I traded the breakout on a new scalp account. I mean, I'm so long, it's unreal. But this is the latest trade for the scalp account. I think for this is like the deceiving thing when you're trading the BTC USD pair, like 31. This is actually, I think, about $900,000 coming on a million, I think, 31 Bitcoin now. It changes every day, but I think this is about 1 million. And basically, really simply, this was one that took the breakout on. Okay, took the breakout on it. And that's $8,000 in, well, literally 30 minutes. And so I'm going to talk you through how I read the market today because, I mean, I think there's so much that you can learn from me. It's unreal. I've traded this just so well, literally just so well. So how did I recognize, firstly, where we were literally going to bottom today, then the levels to compound? I was giving all the compounds and everything. I've just laid this all on a plate, this whole move today, giving you every single level in the chat. But so we have it on video and you can see what I was doing in and out sort of thing, and I can explain it a bit better. But today, the longs, it's been very easy. I want to say easy, to be honest, day of trading. Really, really, really technical. Let me make sure the sound is okay. I was going to go through an Elliott wave count, but I feel there's actually so much you can learn from this video. It kind of doesn't make sense for me to spend the hour going through an Elliott wave count. When we have some real nice in the action price action going on, basically what I'm monitoring right now, I like to monitor, we're on the 1 minute here, but this is normal monitoring the CVD divergences, so we don't really have any yet. We had this really nice bullish CVD here, which was, one could say, maybe invalidated by a tick, but nevertheless, we had some bullish divergences here, where we had a lot of selling going on off of this section, come back down to the lows. I actually compounded this. I would never generally do this, by the way. I've done this for the purpose of the stream. I don't, because I'm going to be talking in and out and I miss a lot of things when I'm talking on stream, I've put my stop loss to break even on this account. I don't generally like to do that, but you know, that's just one of the troubles of being on stream. It's hard to like really hard for me to like go in and out of all the positions and trade and everything while commentating and answering questions. And I'm sure you all understand, it's just really difficult for me to do it. So I don't really like to put stop losses at break even, but yeah, I have on this account for the stream, basically. But what I've been monitoring here is the CVD divergences. So we don't have any on this upwards rise. 85 close, but we didn't have any on that upwards rise coming up for a double top. But you can see here on that pullback we had the bullish divergences, and you got about, I think this is about half a percent, about 0.4% rise. So you know, it's absolutely fine. Possibilities, I suppose, if we get a pullback. I think this is like one of the things that I feel I've done really well, is that I think you just got to take each trade. Like, I feel like one of the ways that I feel as if I trade really well is because you get to a point in trading literally where you've just traded the same thing so many times. It gets to a point where you're like, you know, I win or I lose this trade. Like, literally, it does not matter at the end of the day. I'm either going to win or I'm either going to lose. And I know over a period of time, I win a lot more trades than I lose. But you have to approach every single trade. Like, you don't actually know whether you're going to win or lose the trade, do you? So I'm going to walk you through some of the trades today, which I've traded with, you know, I want to say absolute to the dollar accuracy. But I didn't know when I was taking those trades whether I was going to win or whenever I was going to lose, you understand? So you obviously have to incorporate your risk management when you're trading, because I never, ever, ever know whether my next trades are a winner or a loser, okay? So I think this is really important mindset to get in, okay? And I feel more and more people are getting to that mindset, but you have to approach each trade. Like, I have no idea, really, if I'm going to win or I'm going to lose the next trade. You know, I have no idea. And I'll talk you through some of the commentary from earlier. You have to think, if you trade a breakout in a massive uptrend 10 times, 7 times you should win the trade. The 7 wins equals massive wins. I want a quote unquote massive wins, obviously. The 3 losses are small. I'm okay with the odds of trading the breakout. I know my risk before I enter the trade. So what I'm saying here is, on the breakout, on this example, that we're looking at here, I traded a breakout. And what I'm saying is, you know, I'm getting asked questions sort of, what about if there's a swing failure pattern? And I'm saying, what if there's a swing failure pattern? I mean, one has to say the likelihood is there's not going to be a swing failure pattern, simply because, well, I'll talk you through why I thought there was not going to be a swing failure pattern in a second. But the main point I'm getting to here is I could have been wrong. You know, I could have been wrong. And if you were following along, you actually know I had some breakout orders. Again, this is across accounts, but I had breakout orders, you know, literally 28,489. We're now at 28,800. So it was obviously a brilliant trade. And on this account I've taken profits, just so you're aware, because I don't want to log on to this account basically while I'm on stream. But it's this one I had already hit my take profit. And the way that I'm working through, there's so many trades today that I can talk you through that are actually so good. You have to be really excited, honestly, for this stream. There's so much knowledge you can take when I think of this. Like, so what I done on this trade is I recognized first this resistance. Like, oh no, we've come back, we've back tested. Okay, fair enough. But what I was looking at on this trade, okay, is we had a this first resistance. Okay, and I'm talking you through the breakout here as we're actually pulling back. Increase in open interest, 700 grand. This would have stopped me out, I suppose. Yeah, I've been stopped out of the trade. I'm absolutely fine with that, by the way. I'm out of this trade now. But still, I can talk you through all the theory behind this trade. And we can obviously look in the moment as this is coming. Maybe it actually just back tests resistance as support. So you're currently going into resistance, into support potentially. So this is where you'd be looking at... I would be looking at this open interest, see if you actually get a flip, because if you flip it, I'm more than happy to mark it straight back into the trade. You know, there's no reason why I can't. Probably 26, 520. What I'd be looking at here is the open interest and the CVD. So CVD, you don't have any bullish CVD divergences. No, there's no bullish CVD divergences here. The other thing you'd obviously be looking at is really simply resistance into support. And you kind of do, you literally do. So I've gone back into it. Simply, really simply, resistance into support. If we come down one more time, then what you'd be wanting to look at here is I would anyway want to see some bullish divergences on this section. So from this low to this high, I'd want to see some bullish divergences into this, to be honest with you. Delta is still increased, so you're getting some positive. So this is on this candle, you had 6 million longs open. So obviously your increase in open interest on this one is longs opening up here. This is neutral, but this is 16 million longs. Sorry, 16 million shorts. This is 4 million shorts. Then this is the buyback of 6 million longs. What I would be looking at really simply now is 2 points. I'll be looking for this to potentially make the higher low. Again, I've just bought back in already. Like, I don't mind, but I'm kind of anticipating, I suppose. But what you want to see is either a pullback here to make the higher low, and you want to see a little bit of bullish divergences, or alternatively, you literally come back into this and then you have your SR flip. And it looks like you're going to get the SR flip. And now you're going obviously into this resistance support. You've still got the longs opening. This is good though. So this is good. So you did have the back test. You did have the back test, but basically you back tested it on, well, you've back tested it. You've got this increase in open interest. So you've actually got the buyback potential. Now, obviously you're going into resistance support. So what's the level to reclaim? Well, I would really say, I'm looking at this chart, I'd really say you want to reclaim here 28,770 is what I would say you want to claim. This is on the Tether chart. And if we reclaim that, then I'll add more. And if we lose that low, then I'll actually close. Okay. I'm a bit annoyed that I got stopped on it, because if I didn't have my stop loss at break even, I wouldn't have got stopped. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Yeah, so really what you're looking at here is, oh well, 28,770. That's the level I think you want to reclaim. If you reclaim that, that's where I would compound. Okay. If you don't reclaim it, you come down for the low. You'd want to see the drop off in open interest. You'd want to see the bullish divergences. Even here, you're starting to form quite a bit. You're in the selling. So you got 2 million. So you got quite 6.8 million selling into this. This is new shorts opening. So they're obviously selling the retest. So yeah, this 28,770 really important, because then you've actually got nearly 7 million shorts opening here on the retest. So if the retest fails, then, you know, they're all underwater trying to short the retest. But if the retest works and we head down, well, obviously a really good trade from the people shorting the retest. I'm not really interested. I'm not going to short the retest. You know, it's not really a trade I'd like. I don't feel like trying to short a retest of the all-time high. I say that on one of my accounts I did short. I'm going to share with you, because I've got multiple browsers, I'm going to share with you one trade that I took. Shall I share? No, I don't really want to actually. Yeah, I don't want to do that. But anyway, let's just see how this goes. So 28,770, that's the level to reclaim. Really simply, it says support resistance at the moment. You've got nearly 7 million shorts opening into the retest on an increase in open interest. So, you know, that's new shorts. They're actually trying to defend the retest, or they've just got really aggressive on the breakdown. You had 16 million shorts here in this candle. So in a matter of minutes, we've seen over, you know, easily over 20 million here. So it's a really interesting retest. You're doing two retests. You're doing a higher term time frame retest of this resistance into support, while you're doing a low term time frame retest of the all time high lows into resistance. So one of those retests is obviously going to win. Okay, you're either going to get the bulls winning and we come back acceptance into this range, or you get the bears winning and we actually fill this lower wick and we head our way back down. I think you can look at it. I suppose you can look at it 50-50 right now. To be honest, you can look at it 50-50 simply because you've actually got a lot of new positions opening on both sides. Okay, here's 6.8 million of longs opening. So literally, it's very, 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 very even. 6.8 million new shorts, 6 million new longs. Obviously, this was 6 million new longs. No real divergence. I would say it's 50-50. Maybe bears have a slight upper hand because it is a high term time frame rejection. I mean, it's you've got this really slight. There's a slight divergence. I'd say bears maybe have the upper hand slightly. And now you've got the bullish CVD. So there's your 10 million. Well, this is actually longs closing. So this is, there's 10 million longs that have just closed, but there it has formed the bullish CVD divergence now. So that's kind of what I wanted to see. If we take that high, I'll reclaim, you know, I'll compound. You know, it's as simple as that. I think you just got to get to a stage where you see the data. You know, I see this data, I take the trade. I can win or I can lose. You know, I can win or I can lose. It doesn't really affect me. But, you know, we see the signs. You see the signs over and over and over and over again. And, you know, you just act on it, I suppose, don't you? But yeah, this is nice for me. I've now got the bullish CVD divergences. We see 10 million longs closing here. Again, I'd prefer this if this was 10 million shorts opening. That would be my preference. I'd have liked to have seen the open interest increase on that, but it didn't increase. So, you know, just trading with what I got, I suppose. But yeah, this is still bears with the upper hand until we reclaim that resistance. So I'm really wanting to see them reclaim that. And I'm filling orders at market, by the way. You know, some people will try and fill it at long, limits, but I kind of just view it as the price of doing business, I suppose. Like I'm not really bothered about paying on my market fees. 50-50, I suppose, at the moment. I'm pretty happy that we got the bullish CVD on this really small section, but it doesn't really mean enough to me until we can reclaim this level. Remember what I've done this in the contender stream where I was teaching this. The bullish CVD only comes into effect if you actually change the market structure. So here on the 1 minute chart, for this bullish CVD to actually mean anything, we need to take this high. Okay, we need to take that high for the bullish CVD to mean anything. And then if it means something, then I'll happily compound, you know. But yeah, here we are at the moment. So I have compounded back into this 26 Bitcoin. Thing is, I have no idea anymore how much 26 Bitcoin is, but yeah, I'm slightly annoyed that I'm slightly annoyed that I got stopped at the break even price, because that's really not something I would ever do. But yeah, no, there you go. Nevertheless, so I'm going to actually compound this in. I don't know, I'll compound another 5 Bitcoin. Do this. 570. It hasn't quite taken it on this exchange. So I really want to see 570. We actually got to 550. Just want to see 20 more dollars. And I've literally got my button over the market buy. I'll just show you. So I just want to see. Just want to see it above 570. The problem is, when I'm doing it on stream, I only have this one monitor that it records. I just want to see it get above 570, and then that's really, really, really good. Okay, we're back into that local range. I then have a really easy invalidation to work off as well, you know. Oh, right. Yeah, I kind of didn't want to go above. I didn't want to go above 30 leverage, actually, so I can't put 5 Bitcoin on this account. Yeah, on an account like times 30 is like the max leverage that I want to use. I'm not going to do that, actually. I can just do maybe 2, I think. I will talk you through the rest of the trades from today. I just really want to just see how this plays out really quickly. I'm sure you understand. I'm just waiting for 20 more dollars to see whether I compound this or not. Mm-hmm. What was my original? I'm trying to think on this. So 489. What level did we retest? 8,000. Oh, nice. Okay. Yeah, we didn't retest this entry price either, so that's actually pretty good. We retested on Bybit, obviously, that exchange. We retested 509 on USDT, 512. So we actually done some really nice, retests. And you just look at it like this. Resistance, support. I'm running out, unless I increase my leverage, I'm actually running out of margin here. Thing is, the way that I'm doing these accounts at the moment is I don't want to have lots of Bitcoin on one account. So I've kind of split up Bitcoin between accounts, and it makes more sense. You know, you use like 25 leverage. You know, it's a safe amount of leverage to use, especially with my invalidations. I'm trading, defined invalidations. You trade basically, you split up your Bitcoin. I don't know, let's say you have 1,000 Bitcoin, you put however much Bitcoin you want. Let's say you have, one Bitcoin. And then let's say you have one Bitcoin, and then instead of trading one Bitcoin on one account, I don't know whether I'd bother doing this if I only had one Bitcoin, but let's just say you had one Bitcoin, then you could put maybe 0.2 Bitcoin on each account, trade times 30 on each account. You know, that's probably trading with about, I don't know, 500,000, I suppose, on each account. It just like decrease your risk. I'm not really, well, I'm going to say I'm not paranoid, but I don't know. It's just, I just done it, you know? I have compounded, by the way. Well, there we go. That was an interesting, that was a nice start to the stream, I suppose, wasn't it? Bounce to percent. So, la 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 la. La, 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 la. Sorry. I thought this stream might go crazy. It's really hard. I don't know whether you guys and girls appreciate me trying to do this on stream, or whether you had just preferred me to do. It's just really hard for me sometimes to commentate while I'm actually trying to actually think what I'm doing. Because I kind of don't want to mess up. Yeah, hopefully this stays a little bit stable now. And I'll talk you through these trades, because honestly, the trades today were nothing short of, brilliant, if I say so myself. Okay, so you can see here what's happening. Yeah, there's the point of control, and we kind of retested that. Obviously I'm not really bothered. I do think we'll get above it, but I'm just pointing out why we are pulling back slightly here. You know, I'm just pointing it out. I'm obviously not going to short this. But yeah, I think now we can see this. I think it actually traded really nicely on the retest, you know, when you're monitoring it. And this is the thing, obviously. Yeah, again, I repeat, I am a bit annoyed that I got stopped at break even, because I would never, ever, ever put a stop at break even when I'm doing this generally. But anyway, the reason why I bought back in straight away is because we got the move down. Okay, we had obviously that 16 mil. That's a big one. 16 mil followed by 3.7 mil. The buyback instantly on the increase in open interest of 5.7 mil followed by the 2.9 mil. This was for me, buy. Then we obviously got the pullback with the bullish CVD divergences. This was my eyes lighting up. Okay, this was probably a good idea, because again, I could have been wrong. You know, I could have been wrong here. I buy in another, I think about 800,000, and price could have fell down. You know, it could have fell down and I could have got stopped out. Again, I'm trading the game of probabilities. There was no certainty I was going to be right on rebuying back in. You know, there's no way I could have 100% said I could have actually lost this trade and I could be down. I'm now up again $5,000. So I could have been down $5,000 right now, but I'm not, because I got it right. What we done was we pulled back there, would have gained a 10 million sell, creating those bullish divergences, and then, well, we're now coming back up to that point of control. We're right on it, more or less. So that's a quick talk through of what happened. I'm really not... Yeah, okay. Yeah, it looks really nice for me. I'm really not worried about it. So I'm going to talk you through then some of the trades of today. And I recommend you get out your notepads, because, yeah, the trades were really, really, really good. On a day that I was like really passively trading, I didn't really want to take any trades today, to be honest with you guys. It's just like, literally, I was like, I'm not going to take any trades today. This was me waking up in the morning. I thought, I'm not going to take any trades. And then sometimes when you go on the charts, and I literally spent probably in total about 5 minutes, and I'm up now today, 30 grand. And I spent about 5 minutes looking at the chart, and sometimes you just see it, and I'm just thinking to myself, I just cannot not take this trade. You know, it's 5 minutes of my time, 5 minutes for 30 grand, you know, it kind of works out, take the trade. So I'll talk you through it now. Really, really, really simple, easy trading. Easy, easy, easy. First one was really simply the back test of the daily open. Okay. So if you look back through my posts today, you'll know, and this was from right in the morning, like literally right in the morning. You'll know basically that my thought process today was, yeah, in my opinion, max pain is just carry on up. People want a drop to buy. So keep or so, I don't even know what I'm saying here. Basically, I've been saying this since 9 a.m. this morning. Everybody really wants a big drop. Everybody wants a big drop. Why do they want a big drop? Because everybody's missed buying this trend. And I'm telling you, I just don't understand how or why. There's no real reason there needs to be a pullback. Look at the trend. I mean, just look at it. I mean, just look at that trend. Why on earth are there people obsessed with shorting this? And you can see from those bullish divergences that we had bullish divergences here, 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 here. Like, people are obsessed with shorting this. And let me tell you, it's 100% like newer noob traders. I'm sure of it, because there's no good trader, in my opinion, can short this. And I'm talking obviously from a swing trader's perspective, as we just took the higher game. This is really good. I'm gonna need to up the margin. I kind of didn't want to, but there you go. We're gonna have to go like times. This account, we're gonna have to probably go like times 40 leverage. That's cool. And I'm just going to do this really quickly. Bear with me a second. That is. Cool. There you go. Let me talk you through my thought process. Yeah. So basically what happened here was we had this move above the highs last night. Okay. And it was a sustained period. Actually, you had and you have to think I'm there's obviously zero hindsight in this. You know, this is what I said this morning straight away. We spent 1 hour 45 above the highs. Okay. And what happens is we had a big sell-off, you know, quote unquote, big sell-off. And why? And I want to show you the bullish divergences on these sell-off, yeah? So this is what I saw. I saw this bullish divergence. Look at this. 41 million sells. 89 million sells. And I'm saying to myself, wow. 89 million, 41 million sells in an uptrend into daily open retests. Is that a long position with those bullish divergences? In my opinion, yes, it is. It's not just the technicals here. I'll tell you this for a fact, like, it's not just the technicals here that made me want to buy, but it's actually understanding the market and the dynamics of the market and why the market's moving. it's understanding this. You know, you have to have an understanding, because I think, you know, we have some really well respected technical analysis in the group, but and obviously them and other people outside of the group, etc., etc., people were looking for lower. People were expecting retests such as 26K, okay, looking for a one-to-one. Okay, people were generally looking for lower prices today, I feel, and saw. But my perspective was, we're not going to lose that low. And everybody waiting for lower is once again going to miss out, as they've been doing time and time and time and time and time and time and time again on this uptrend. People are just missing out, missing out, missing out, missing out, missing out, missing out, because people are waiting for this 30% drop. You know, people are waiting for these big drops. Where's the big drop that everybody's waiting for? I mean, it's just not there, is it? You know, I'm not going to get caught up anymore in this, but basically, I just recognized that I just felt it was very unlikely that price was going to take out this low. Why? Because we had the bullish. So from the technical reasons, it's because we had the bullish divergences. From the reading the market perspective, well, I just felt as if we were in a scenario where many people had, literally my exact words, max pain. So we just carry on up here because so many people want to buy the dip. I just don't feel the market's going to give this dip that everybody's waiting for until the top's in. And then there comes a big drop and everybody buys the dip. And then the market continues down, you know, that's how the market works. You got to know when to be aggressive. I suppose you got to know when to be aggressive. You got to know to accept you're wrong as well. You know, I totally accept I could have been wrong this morning. And I think this is just the massive, massive, massive thing. You have to accept you're wrong when you're wrong. And you have to accept that risk. You know, you have to accept when I'm entering here, before I'm entering, I know where I'm wrong. Okay, so this morning I started off with a smaller position because obviously, you know, I'm trading off of the big move to the downside. The risk here is, you know, it's not the best long. Okay, where's the best long? Okay, the really, 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 really simply, where's the best long here? Well, I'll show you right now. The best long today was this one right here. Low to high. There you are, into the CC. Okay, there you are, into the CC. I mean, why are you not taking this trade? This is the one to take. Okay, this is the one. If you're going to take one trade today, it had to be this. Why? Well, there's your entry. There's your invalidation below the low. I was looking for the highs. We're talking about 3-to-1 plus risk to reward ratio. And just so you can actually see the post today of like live updating the time as I was doing this. I've done a lot of posts. I'll show you it. Because I did do this one. Yeah, basically I was buying more and buying more. So like I'm telling you everywhere, I'm buying more here because I'm expecting upside. That was while price was at 28,400. You know, I'm just buying more and buying more and buying more because I'm very confident, I suppose, in my plans. But I want to find the post from this. Yeah, there you go. So this is again live update in the time, but there's me buying 27,605 at limit. And let me show you this, what it looked like. So it's a really, really, really great trade, if I'm honest. But basically, I showed everyone, here we are hitting the CC. You know, I'm giving this one away. Here we are hitting the CC. Okay. And then I waited a little bit. And what we had was, there's the CC entry, 27,605. As you can see, that's the lower CC, 20,607. And then what I done was I market bought more when we changed the 1 minute market structure. So we changed the market structure. So I'm entering an initial position at the CC. You know, it's fairly low risk. Why is it fairly low risk? Well, I know we're in a massive uptrend. I know my idea is that we're going to be taking this high today. And I know where I'm wrong, which is coming back down below daily open. You know, that's where we had all the shorts. All these shorts are out. That's where I know I'm wrong. And then what have I done here? I've bought at that level. I'm trading my plan. And then I've market bought more when we've changed the 1 minute market structure. So once we've done that 1 minute market structure, I'm not going to go to the 1 minute here and see, but basically once we've changed 1 minute market structure, you know, that's then given me, okay, you know, there's the compounds, there's the compound into this. And really simply rode it up. I rode it up to before the highs. So I actually traded this slightly differently and I'll explain why. So I traded it like this. So I actually had my average entry was 27,630. Pretty sure my average doesn't really matter to you lot, but pretty sure my average entry after that entry, and then the compound was about 27,630. But basically what I done on this trade, and this was a really, really, really clever trade. And I want to try and find, I don't need to find the, try and find the post. 3 pages. Basically my, what I done was I used this line, which is the last high. Okay. And what I'm looking at is the high. This was the swing failure of the high. When you lose that level, this level can act, you know, generally will act as resistance again. Okay. So what I've done is I've took this resistance level, which was the high before a swing failure pattern, and I've marked it. And so I come down to the 1 minute chart, and it was so perfect. What I've done is I took profit. I closed out everything. Okay. And this was exact words that I put. I closed out all my long at this resistance, because I know that this resistance could potentially cause a pullback. Okay, we could reject here and head down lower. So what I'm saying to myself is, okay, I'm going to close all my long here. And I did. Closed everything. I closed all my long there. And really simply what I done was I put a conditional market order to buy as soon as we come back above that high. Because then what I'm saying to myself is this is the resistance. You know, I've got it to the dollar. Pretty within $10, we got a rejection. Okay, and again, the pullback here is of, you know, 0.7%. So we got the pullback at the exact level I'm waiting for. Again, I sold all my long. And what I've done is I've placed a conditional market order above the high. So what this is telling me is if we get above this high, it's got through the resistance that I sold at. So things to take in mind. In my opinion, this is a really, really, really good and clever way to trade. Why might some people not like this way of trading? You're going to use a few extra fees. You know, obviously, I'm going to get back in again at market, you know, so I've got a market fee. I don't care. Advantages of this is if we had actually rejected it, this resistance, which was possible, you know, I'm out of the trades, you know, I'm out of the longs, and price could have dumped here and I would have walked away with a really, really good day of trading, you know. But, you know, fortunately or not fortunately, I suppose, is we got through that level. And what we actually done was this level, we broke it. We even back tested it, and then we got another move to the upside. And again, that move to the upside after the back test was for another 1.67%. And obviously, on my main account, I have taken profits at those highs, because that for me was just like I'm more than happy with where we got up to. So this what I'm doing on stream now is obviously just a sub account of mine. I'm not really too bothered about it, if I'm honest. But my main account took profits up at those highs, more than happy with it. And this what's happening now, we'll see how it goes. But yeah, main account has taken profits, by the way, on the long. Yeah, but basically, yeah, the resistance broke, back tested it as support. We got a move to the upside. So you can see how amazingly technical today was. Really, 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 really technical trading. Firstly, rejection, daily open to basically the dollar. Yeah, dollar daily open, move up back into the CC, close everything at resistance, reclaim resistance as support. Well, I actually had just a conditional market order. Come back into that trade. We got another move to the upside. Questions that I would probably ask myself is this is not really the best breakout I've ever seen in my life. You know, let's be honest, this is not really amazing breakout. Generally on a breakout, what you would want to see is if I would be honest, I'd probably want to see after this retest, you know, we've done the retest. You know, this is the retest now. We've retested, I would say, this. We've retested the block. What you generally want to see is a bit more follow through, a bit quicker follow through. If I'm totally honest, this is not really what I'd want to see. You know, obviously if I had a choice, I'd want to see a bit more quicker follow through. You know, what am I thinking here? I suppose I'm I think you got a little bit of indecision here, but I think you all got to remember what you got to remember is where have been the highly probable trades today. Really, the highly probable trade was the CC. I feel that even the retest here was a second highly probable trade. Like those were the two trades of the day. I trading here is not really a good trade. When you got to think of if you're trying to maybe rate your trades from 1 to 10, CC was a 10 out of 10 trade. The retest there was probably about a, you know, 6 out of 10 trade. It was technical. As you know, if you're buying here, it's not really, you know, you're literally buying, you know, it's not really a good time to buy, is it? Let's be honest. So if you're looking at this of a perspective of who's buying here, You know, I want someone else to buy here, but I guess if I'm rating this on a scale of, is this a good buy up against what you can have? And obviously this is not a very good buy, like literally at this level, it's not really that good in the grand scheme of things. What I'm trying to get across to you here is if you're trying to only take the best trades, and you only want to take the best trades, so you don't want to take everything. You know, I did buy up here, so let's just remember that I bought up here. But what I'm trying to say is, if you're not at this level, or you're not at this, I don't know, really know the right words, I suppose, but if you only want to take the best trades, like, I would honestly say that this is not one of those best trades. This is a little bit of a, you know, what, you know, there's a technical reason there. There's a setup there, but it's not really one of the best trades you're ever going to see, is it? This is a really substandard, I would, you know, it's just an average, really average trade. You get a few good trades a day. This is not a good trade, really, if I'm totally honest with you. I can't remember the point that I was trying to make across here. I've lost my train of thought. But yeah, I've lost my train of thought there. Really, what I'd be looking at here is if we form, again, just see if we keep forming bullish CVD, because literally on every single drop that we get, people just are absolutely obsessed with shorting Bitcoin. And I think it's really crazy. And honestly, in my opinion, it's just like, at some point, these shorts are going to get it right. You know, yeah, at some point, they're going to get it right. But and the thing is that people like this will celebrate shorting the high of Bitcoin. But what you have to think is they've been stopped out 20 times in a row. Where my mythology here has been, you know, I'm going to keep buying the dips, you know, and I've got it right 20 times so far out of 20 times, you know. So who's the better trader? The guy in this uptrend that's bought the dip 20 times and won 20 trades, or the guy that's trying to short this uptrend 20 times, he's lost 20 times, maybe he gets it right on the 21st time and he becomes celebrated, I suppose. But he's down a lot of money and I'm up a lot of money. I mean, what you got to think is, it's so obvious. The thing is, I think people are blinded by it. You know, honestly, this is a really big factor of trading. People are blinded by, I mean, look at this chart. If you're in no position, what are you doing? Are you buying or are you selling this chart right now? Like, if you're in no position at all, what do you think you're doing in this chart? What would you actually be doing, buying or selling? And I hope the answer, and obviously we're talking about a swing trader's perspective, I'm not on about a 1 minute chart here, but from a swing trader's perspective, I hope your answer is I'm buying, because this is such a nice uptrend. I just do not understand. Well, I do understand it, I suppose, but in an uptrend, you know, people lose the most amount of monies in these trends, and it's either from a majority of reasons, I suppose. People not having the patience. I mean, people complaining that there's no dips to buy when there actually has been massive dips to buy in this uptrend. Okay, last week we swing failure pattern the low of the range. Remember this? We had a range. We had this kind of. And we had the low, you kind of swing fire pattern the low. That's a major dip in an uptrend. You had this dip here. And this dip here, by the way, was an absolute perfect dip to buy. You know why this was an absolute perfect one-to-one extension? High of the move, low of the move, bring it back up. You went into the one-to-one extension. Again, really, really easy kind of buy, I would say. I mean, this is I didn't take this long here because I wasn't actually, you know, I didn't take this long here, but I suppose if you were around at the time, 5:50, I was asleep. But if you're around at 5:15 and you kind of get given this opportunity in an uptrend, and we know Bitcoin puts in these deep higher lows, you know, and you're talking about coming back up to that high, maybe you take this as the trade. You know, you're risking 1% for 10%, and it's just trades like this. So you got to think, okay, you know. You know, I'm just thinking to myself again. There's dips in the uptrends. You know, people that say there's no dips to buy, I just wrong actually. You just got to be aggressive, I suppose, on the uptrend. But yeah, that's pretty intense day of trading. I really wanted to just talk you through this. I wanted to talk you through that daily open long, that long offer to CC, closing that resistance, re-longing into support, getting aggressive on the retest of really simply resistance into support retest. That worked out on stream pretty nice. We don't have any bullish CBD quite yet. But basically, I love to just monitor the open interest with the CBD and the Delta. I feel that this like just gives you such a, and I want to just go, it kind of gives you a really nice advantage, I suppose. Yeah, it's pretty nice. Oh, blimmin' hell, man. I'll do some questions. I'll do some questions now. If there is any. I hope you are all having a nice holiday. I've not noticed any delayed data, to be honest with you. I don't know, I've not noticed anything delayed. We just bounce off the CC there. All right, look at that. 618 to the 618 to the dollar we just bounced off of, by the way. To the dollar. Anyway. Wow, what, that is crazy. We hit 618 to the dollar and it's already a 0.5% bounce. Now that SPX filled the gap, it's really bullish for Bitcoin if it goes up from there, even though Bitcoin raised on its job. I'm not even looking at SPX anymore. I think just literally, you can't place any weight on the ES, like the stock market at the moment. Like Bitcoin is its own asset right now. I don't think you need to look at anything with the SPX. Last time I looked at the SPX, it was strong. It's pulling back slightly. I mean, it really doesn't matter. It's down 0.3%. I think you just look at Bitcoin. Literally just look at Bitcoin. Yeah, I would say just look at Bitcoin. Yeah, you don't need to look at this stock market really. That is brilliant. Yeah, I kind of can see how just watching and listening is. It's a good way to learn, to be honest. I'm glad you enjoy. Nothing goes up forever, absolutely. But if you're sat on the sideline, like I think like to myself anyway, what would I be more annoyed at? Like be sat on the sidelines and literally miss the whole of this uptrend? Or just get aggressive and buy the dips that are given, I think that's kind of like obvious what I'd prefer to do. Obviously, nothing goes up forever. I'm not expecting this to go up forever. But what I am doing is trading aggressively on the massive uptrend that I have. I absolutely expect there to be a drop at some point. You know, I know there's going to be a drop at some point. But, yeah. Anyway, I posted some fib ring charts in Bitcoin local and macro, and they're expecting pretty well that backtest right to the macro 618. But I mean, Tom's analysis is like is above me. It kind of is, but yeah, I mean, that's crazy. And I know you've got these really, really, really nice charts. I mean, I'm not doing this. Obviously, I'm not doing this type of analysis on a daily basis. But I mean, yeah, this is crazy good. It's really impressive. But I'm not going to lie, it is above me. I'm actually not clever enough to be able to do these sort of charts. Yeah, it's crazy, man. That's impressive, dude. It's really nice to see. Bitcoin putting in a little 1 minute channel here with the lower high, lower high, lower high, lower high. Really want to try and break those lower highs. Yeah, man, that's cool. Do you think the max pain logic comes from crypto potentially being, no. My simple answer is just no. Buy the dip. My simple answer is yes. Well, that's what I've been doing and it's been working well for me. Not to distract, but that was a perfect local. Yes, it was. We literally just hit that 618 to the dollar. I just noticed that myself as well. That was amazing. Any tips for someone just starting trading in this massive uptrend? It seems the CC and the VWAP being so well respected the last few days may create a false sense of security. It can't always be that easy. But it has been that easy recently. Literally, it has been that easy recently. I kind of feel like longing. What's ETH doing right now? 217. Palm, he wants to long ETH. I'll do that later. Yeah, tips, I suppose. Well, false sense of security. I think you're approaching trading the wrong way. You are totally approaching it the wrong way. If you're saying to yourself, the CC and the VWAP is being well respected. So let's just say you have a rule set that says, I'm going to buy the CC at the VWAP. And I'm making this up, but the last 10 times it's hit in this uptrend. And this is probably right, by the way, but this is off the top of my head. Let's say you've just got a rule that says, I'm going to buy the CC and the VWAP in the uptrend. And in this uptrend, actually, the last 10 times it's hit, 8 times it's worked. So you've actually got an 80% win rate, and the winners have been much bigger than the losses too. On top of that, then you're saying to me, it can make a false sense of security. But if you're approaching every single trade I can actually lose, why have you got the false sense of security in the first place? If every trade I'm taking, I say, I can actually lose this trade. There's no security in the first place, is there? Because I know I'm actually playing a totally random result. I know over time this has got, let's say, an 80% win rate, but my next loss can be one of those. It can be one of the two losses of the 10. So I know every single trade I'm taking can actually be a loss. There's absolutely 0000 guarantee I have that my next trade is a winner. All I know is over a string of trades, okay, over my 10 trades, I'm going to walk out with 8 wins likely. But I know that 2 of them are going to be a loss. So I have no expectations of actually winning that trade. I enter the trade and think, right, this is going to win or it's going to lose. If it loses, okay, absolutely fine. I'll move on to my next trade, which statistically speaking should work in a winner. But I have no sense of security in the first place. So my answer to you is, why would you not buy the CC and the VWAP in the uptrend when statistically speaking, it's working really well? And you're approaching each time you're actually longing that as, yeah, it can fail. But so can any, I just don't understand why you would not take it because of the false sense of security. Obviously, the trade is not going to work every single time. So if you remove the expectation of the trade winning and you enter that trade thinking it's going to win or it's going to lose, then where's your sense of security in the first place? Are you not going to take the CC in the VWAP because you're scared of it not working? And I would say your answer is yes. Like, you are not taking that because you're scared it's going to be the one time it loses. But if you're trading this consistently over a period of time, why would you be scared that this trade is going to lose when statistically speaking, it's been working very well? That would be my answer to you. How do you get such defined CVD lines? Mind belly moves. I don't know, probably because I'm on the 1 minute chart. This is just the 1 minute chart, I suppose. Will there be profit taken around in a year? again, this is really hypothetical, and I mean, I'm not going to be saying whether there's going to be profit taken or not. I mean, all we can do is trade our own. We can just trade what we have on the charts. Again, these sort of theories, or is this going to happen? Is this going to happen? Is this going to happen? You know, I read this on YouTube that this is going to happen. Read this on a forum that this is going to, you know, it really doesn't matter. Is there going to be profit taken around the year? I don't know. And honestly, I don't care. It does not affect me in the slightest. If there's a sell-off, there's a sell-off. And I'll trade a sell-off. But I'm not going to be contemplating whether there is or there isn't, because this is a factor that makes no difference to me. Dan, this is a great stream. I'm happy to hear that. Again, I'd be really careful predicting these sort of things. Yeah. Big pleasure to see how you're managing this trade. Learning from the best. I am more than happy with that. Yeah, Tom's charts are amazing. Daniel, how are you managing your position now? If you were not on stream, that is, like, have your core position, and what kind of scopes would you take here? Expecting a range. I would have liked to have taken like another CC trade here. Like, the CC trades are generally pretty nice in the uptrend, so when you get your nice CC here, I suppose you could see something along the lines of a Gartley type trade. So yeah, you kind of just, I would pull first this. Okay, so what you would obviously look for, again, you're talking about scalps on a low term time frame, but let's say you bought a CC, then where's your take profit? You're probably just going to take profit right into here. So you take profit into the, well, I'd take profit one. I wouldn't close the whole position. But if you take profit here, okay, where's your take profit two? I would say it's literally going to be back above this high. So that's where I would say take profit two is. So you can take profit one here. What you can actually do if you really want to get aggressive is compounds. Literally now, you could buy again now. And so there, what you've done is you've sold here. You've bought back here. And I'd really say then you're looking for this. So you're looking for that. Where are you wrong on this trade? Well, maybe if it just comes back below this low. Depends how much... yeah, it kind of depends. But yeah, those are the sort of trades I'd take. Like really quick CC trades back into the point of control, CC back into the value area high. The more minute channel that I was on about is that I think you've got to be slightly careful. It's because you are doing this. Oh, wow. Actually, so look. So you had the resistance at the... Let's just clear this up a second. So you had high, low, high, into the CC, up, into the CC, up, into the CC. But this was actually also in the middle of the channel. I suppose if you do fall down here, then you still do have this back into this middle of the channel. But yeah, basically that's the answer. I'm not obviously doing it as we're speaking, but that's what I'd be looking for generally. Just post it. Let's see. Yeah, that I would probably say that's some sort of glitch. XO is a little bit glitchy, and I think we all know XO is a little bit glitchy, to be honest. Like that, yeah, that shouldn't be 700 grand when you can clearly see there's several million on that. Yeah, I don't know. I'm not the developer, obviously, so I can't really say, but I would say, yeah, that this is some sort of glitch, and I honestly have no idea why. I'm sorry. I can ask Varan, but I have no idea why that's glitched. Because yeah, for me, that obviously should be much, much lower negative number. It's XO's been glitchy, and I know they're releasing their new software literally very, very, very soon. So I wouldn't worry too much. Yeah, they're releasing like software for the desktop, and it should be coming out really shortly. So EXO's really glitchy at the moment, but like they're going to be releasing new software soon, like desktop software. So yeah, you just got to kind of deal with these glitches for the time being, unfortunately, which obviously is not great. But for me, it doesn't glitch, so I'm happy. But other people in the chat keep saying there's glitches, so I don't know. I've not really experienced any of them, so I can't really say. Maybe try on like hard refreshes, hold control in F5, and sometimes it actually fixes it. I'm happy about that. Just standard session view app. That's what I was going to do tonight. We can probably just do it on the Champions live stream on Sunday. That's what I was going to do tonight, but it's kind of like, if you have the option of just me looking at me doing the Elliott Wave power or looking and listening to me and watching me trade, I feel that there's only one, should only be anyway, one winner of what's more educational, I suppose. The bigger you pull the CVD window. Yeah, that is true. So if you have any other questions, let me know. Oh yeah, we also today, I forgot about this, we also filled a naked daily pointer control. So we had this, we obviously went through that daily naked pointer control. See what we got going on then. VWAP 28100. Just general consolidation. You can't really see anything standing out amazing at the moment. Really like to break out of this, take that value area high, and I'd probably buy some more, you know. To be honest, I'll buy some more. Well, if there's no more questions, that's kind of all that I wanted to go through, really. Well, just a holiday edition. But I feel the holiday edition, but it was pretty nice. I think, I think that people just generally, it's all about confidence. Like, literally, it's all, I feel trading is so much about confidence. Like, it's so important. Like, if you have no confidence in yourself, I just don't see how you can actually be a successful trader. Even if you're like following the same, like today I've literally posted on an absolute, you know, I've just posted exactly what I'm doing, and still I've made money today. But you know for a fact, people, even though they're reading exactly what I'm doing, can still lose money, because at the end of the day, I suppose they don't have that confidence and experience that I have. And so two people looking at the exact same chart with the exact same data, you know, we're trading it differently, I suppose. And it's crazy. But, you know, this was something that I feel that you could all read, which I think hopefully is pretty helpful. I'm not going to sit here and read it all, but yeah, this was a nice post that you might want to spend some time and read through. I suppose I'll just read out the last one. No, it's hard to do. Obviously, we're talking about trading. Know it's hard to do when starting out, but eventually, after you evolve into a successful trader, you will only focus on the now of trading. I won't care about big wins or big losses or how much money I'm making. I'll be focused on the next trade and making good trades overall. So what am I saying here? I think it's like when you're actually experienced, you know, I can say for a fact, my own trading, like, I'm not thinking about the money, you know, I'm not focused on the P&L, I'm not thinking, you know, I guess it comes down even to something as simple as the market fees. You know, if I'm here thinking to myself, oh my God, on my position here, you know, each market fee is costing me about $1,000. You know, so in at $1,000, out at $1,000, in at $1,000, you know, I've spent easily spending probably in a day 10 grand in market fees. But if I'm making 10 grand in market fees, you know, obviously making a lot more in the actual trades. But I think it just comes down to, if I'm sat here all the time scrutinizing every single little bit of fee, if I'm thinking to myself, you know, if I'm just staring at the P&L all day, I don't think I can make money trading, you know, to be, you know. And I went through this process. Obviously, when I started out trading, I was obsessed with recording every single trade that I made, how much I'm winning, how much I'm losing, setting daily goals. When I hit the daily goal, stop trading, all these things that kind of, you, when you start trading, is kind of, I suppose, the norm. But the more I progress as a trader, the more that I started to realize, actually, I should not be focusing on money. What I should be focusing on is taking my trade. And if I just focus on the process, and if I just focus on building up my skills as a trader, well, the money's coming on its own. And so when you go from being obsessed with the money, winning money, losing money, everything, you know, the fear of losing money is a big thing. So not only being obsessed when you begin trading with wanting to win every trade, not only being obsessed with wanting to end green, but also being obsessed with not losing a single dollar because you're under the expectation of, I'm doing this analysis because I'm right. You know, once you lose that kind of mentality and you're just thinking to yourself, right, I'm taking this next trade, the trade's going to win or it's going to lose. I know where I'm right, I know where I'm wrong. And I'm going into this trade not thinking about the money, but I'm thinking about the process behind the trade and the technical reasons behind the trade. You know, the money actually starts to come on its own. You know, I'm not having to look every day how much I've made and how much I've lost, but I can come in once a month, look at my account, and I'm seeing my account going up and up and up and up and up. And well, that's just the product of taking good trades. And how do I take good trades? Well, it's actually because I'm not obsessed with the money. You know, I'm not obsessed with thinking on every trade how much I'm making, how much I'm losing. You know, a lot of people, they take a good trade. You know, let's say for an example, they take a $100,000 trade, which I suppose for a lot of people is a lot of money, but they get a 1% move and then they see $1,000 profit. And maybe for them, they're thinking, oh my God, that $1,000, this is so much. If I get stopped out now and a $1,000 win turns to a $1,000 loss, I'm going to be like so annoyed. It's going to, you know, I'm not going to sleep. It's going to be so stressful, you know, and then they move their stop up to break even. They get stopped out for $0, and then price goes up to target and they would have made $10,000. And then, you know, you can just see it. Why did they get stopped out there? Well, they got stopped out because they were so scared of losing the unrealized P&L that they've actually just missed out on missing 10 grand. And then you can see how this cycle is going to repeat of, well, now they've just got missed out on 10 grand. That's going to psychologically affect you on the next trade, isn't it? And it all started from the process of being so obsessed with the money. If you had actually just traded the chart and traded your plan, you would have had more money. You know, it's really funny trading, but that's exactly how it works. Like 100%, that's exactly how it works. And so how do you break that? This is really great, by the way. I'm so happy with Bitcoin. But, you know, how do you break that cycle? Well, you kind of break the cycle by doing things like this. You know, you take those best trades, you know, you divorce yourself from, you know, being so obsessed with each cent of the market. You know, and here you go, self-belief, believe in yourself. If you don't believe in yourself, you know, I've said this a lot. If you don't believe in yourself, no one else is going to believe in you. If you think you're a loser and you come into the market every day thinking of yesterday's losses, you're not going to win, are you? If I take a big loss in the night before I sleep, you know, I'm not waking up the next, you know, I'm not going to be thinking about it at all while I'm sleeping. And then when I wake up, I'm not going to be thinking about yesterday's loss the first thing I do when I start trading. No. Whereas many people, if they take a really big loss in the night, that firstly, they're going to have a sleepless night. Then they're going to wake up the next day and trade rubbish because they're still affected by their loss because they're a loser. You know, you got to get out of this loser's mentality. Seriously, like point number four is really big here. Point number four is really big. It's a lot about a mentality. And where was that post? Yeah, this was a really, really nice post that I liked. This one here. Yeah, I think this was a really, really good post that you can kind of pause and read. But yeah, there you go. That's what I wanted to talk about here. I'm going to buy some more Bitcoin. I've got such a big position size right now. But I'm going to have to up my leverage even more. This is pretty funny, but... I started at times 30 and I'm up to times 85 leverage. But that's all right. Yeah, that's brilliant. So I hope you've all enjoyed this stream. It's been fun for you to watch. We've absolutely nailed each of these moves. Really nice. I hope that you have had a brilliant time watching on that stream. We're walking away now with... $23,000. Not bad. And that's it then. So I hope you've enjoyed. I'll catch you on Sunday stream. We'll be going back to normal with the lessons and everything. I hope you've enjoyed. I want to say thank you very much and have a brilliant, brilliant evening, everybody.
So I really hope that you've enjoyed and learned a lot from that video and you've got a glimpse into some of the magic that we're doing here on a daily basis inside Chart Champions. And what I want to show you now is after that stream ended, I continued trading for the rest of the night. And within the Champions group, I was doing continuous updates of my trades. Even before this, the way that we were selling that 886, that 886 was sold by us, relonged the CC. And, so we've been going pretty well throughout the night. But what I want to continue on here is the way that this channel ended. Again, I was looking down for the 786 here. Bottom of the channel would be a nice trade, waiting patiently. And I think this is the important thing. We've got to wait patiently because what we saw here was then the move down to the bottom of the channel. Okay, really, really perfectly. We got the move back up, retested that channel once again, move back up. This is the 1 minute chart. Remember, it's the 1 minute chart, but we're trading this with such accuracy. I feel it was a nice one to show you through this. Over all of this, then after buying the low here, I wanted to sell into the middle of channel confluence with this downwards trend line that I recognized. Okay, so remember, I've just longed here. And even before this, I had actually sold the 886, bought a CC of this, waited then for the 786, re-compounded on the 786, and then I'm looking to sell the trend line, okay? Because it's the trend line in the middle of my channel. Okay, so again, this is all live in the time. There's no hindsight. This is before it happens. You can check the timestamps. We're moving down, and what we saw was the absolute, within $5 touch of the middle of the channel with the trend line. So then I've sold. Okay, I've sold here. I've shorted, I suppose is the better word. And I'm waiting for a little bit of a drop to occur. And there I got my drop. So we got the drop, resistance into support, again to the pretty much the dollar, close that short, and I'm going back into a long as soon as we take the trend line, okay? And so we move down. I'm saying right here we are, I'm in my zone, everything's looking really well. We took the trend line, and then what I'm doing here is, again, 2 minutes past, literally this was 11 seconds past, went back into a long position. At 28,933, because we had got through this trend line, and now I'm looking for another move to the upside. Okay, so if we continue down, there you go, look at that. So from selling the 886 to buying the CC to reselling the CC to waiting patiently for the 786 to buying the 786 to compounding the 786 to selling the trend line to rebuying, well, actually just selling the short of the resistance back into support, to longing the break of the trend line, to getting that massive move to the upside, that's a take profit. That was obviously the top of the channel. I'm just going to cough for a second. Okay, so what I've said, starting from this morning, that CC trade, I'd literally traded each step of that whole range absolutely perfectly. I'm going to say it was pretty impossible to have traded it better, because each pivot of this range, I've actually traded each exact pivot of the range. It's pretty hard to have traded better than that. Ending the day with $158,000 profit, and that's from making new Bitcoin, not just holding spot. And then this was then another trade that I took. So then this was another trade that I took of a break of the high. Okay, so we just made this bigger. I took a break off the high and then taking it back up again. So this is then a separate trade. So this is then a breakout trade. Again, we're in an uptrend. I'm happy to trade the breakouts. And that was 35 Bitcoin. So that's about $1 million. And so literally 10 grand in 10 minutes from trading a breakout in an uptrend. You know, you're trading with the trend. The trend is your friend. Obviously, we're taking profits. But that's a really nice way of approaching trading, I think. Then I was asked this question. Is this something that can be learned through the videos on the website? This is a champion that's only been in the group, you know, a week. So I guess he hasn't had time to look through it. But this is a question that I'm saying, yes, for sure. If you look at the people who have been here a while and studied it, they are trading just as good and consistently too. I'm referring to the people that have been in the group a while, e.g. a long time. And, you know, they've studied the content. They've learned from the content. And now they are doing the same as me, trading consistently. And that's obviously the one thing you're aiming for is consistency over time. It's not just making one good trade. You know, it's not just making five lucky trades, I suppose, but it's doing the same thing consistently over time and making money. So yeah, I feel that this was a pretty, just a nice thing to add on to walk you through that we continued to trade very well, in that ending period. And yeah, I hope that you've thoroughly enjoyed that video. You've made some notes, you've learned something. Obviously, if you're interested in joining Chart Champions, then you can go over to the website chartchampions.com. And, you know, if you're interested, sign up in our mentorship. Obviously, Contenders is for the educational content. Champions is if you're interested in these updates that I'm doing throughout the day. And, you know, that's all before it happens, giving each step of the way, before the drops where I'm looking for, before the pumps, when I'm getting into the positions. You know, it's a pretty nice information to have, I suppose. But I hope that you've thoroughly enjoyed this video. I'm going to say have a brilliant new year. And that's cheers from me, everybody. Thank you and goodbye.